school issues, our parents must have something to say.
Arms, we don't need arms for anything. Let them put it into education.
They need to ban other arms now.
What are they fighting for?
Government should deal with them squarely.
Please help us bring back our girls.
No money, no markets. We are dying. Everybody is crying. Nothing.
Any man God support, no man stops.
It's a prophecy I believe he must have received from heaven. Yes.
The people giving voice to the voiceless.
This is the Big Weekend.
All right, welcome back to the Big Weekend. Of course, it's the weekly program that prepares you for a weekend of sporting action. Of course, my name is NNAMDI Obaya, not alone. Here with Biola Obiwole, and of course, we have been dissecting the upcoming weekend and preparing you for it. Of course, if you missed it, we've done our big feature, which was, of course, on Arsenal's chances. We've talked about upset alert for the weekend. I said Newcastle, Southampton. He says Frosinone Inter. So you might want to look into all that. But now it's time for a segment we like to call Usho Baje Baje. If you know what that means, it means it's sure. Very, very sure. We're guaranteeing you that, not guaranteeing you, we're advising you that this is where you can put a lot of money and make a lot of money, you know. Low odds, but fairly sure results. Of course, I mentioned earlier that I did go to the Eredivisie to pick my fixture. And of course, Biola went to the French League. So let's look at our picks for this weekend. I'm saying Cambo versus Ajax. I'm looking at Ajax to win. The odds are 1.31. This, for me, is a sure game. I don't think Campbell stands any chance against one of the, I don't want to call them the one-foot-in people to the title.
Major title contenders.
I mean, it's becoming a two-horse race again.
Yes.
In Holland, between Ajax and PSV. And Ajax against Campbell, you want to look at them as a side that could put this away. Looking at your pick, you've gone for going up against PSG.
Yeah.
PSG to win. And the odds are pretty high at 2.15 for PSG.
You know, one thing that's really funny is that PSG's recent form since they won the league, mathematically speaking, has gone in a bit of a dip.
Okay.
But one thing that I would go for PSG is that their away form has still been good. Okay. You know, the last game that they lost was against Lyon, but in the past five games, that was the only loss they've had. Four wins. You know, so far, the last time Gwingon beat PSG was 2003.
Let's look at things that happened in 2003. There was no Twitter, there was no there was no Instagram. Arsenal were still winning titles. I'm just saying. But if you're looking for sure better, that's our advice. I'm saying, you know, you could look at the Ajax fixture against Campbell, and of course, you can look at Gwingon against PSG. Now, let's move straight to the big list, because to tell you what the big list is, we take a combination of fixtures from as few as 10 to as much as 25, 30 to get you odds. Of course, we very, very safely place our odds when we're picking these fixtures. It's to see how good of analysts we are. And of course, this weekend we put together our list totaling odds of about 171. Meaning if I put 100 naira, I'd probably get 17k. I put 1,000 there. That's 171,000 straight away. But you like I said, you have to see it to believe it. Let's look at this list. Of course, we've done 17 fixtures, all football, and of course we have it right there. Starting with the Eredivisie, of course we said Ajax versus Campbell. Mm-hmm. That's
and,
there.
And we put the Gwingon.
Of course, the Gwingon versus PSG fixture. But again, in Ligue 1, we have Angers versus Ajaccio in that one.
Yeah.
Angers to win or draw. The odds are 1.27. And for some reason, you seem very sure that...
Yeah. the thing about Angers is that I've been following their surprise rise in the Ligue 1 this season. And yes, they might not even make the Champions League spot, but they've had a really good form so far. And looking at how Ajaccio have been playing, you know, Angers look like the better team. They're playing at home. A win or draw seems like a really, very safe bet, in my opinion. For Angers.
And of course, Saint-Étienne, they're always a team that they're dependable, mm-hmm. To say the least. I'm coming up against Troyes at home.
Yeah.
You want to look at Saint-Étienne winning that one.
Troyes relegation threatened. Saint-Étienne, middle of the table, but you know, at home against Troyes, you'd want to give them the 3 points.
Yeah, we've got straight to the Bundesliga. We've given Bayern Munich a win or draw away to Stuttgart. I don't know how much safer you want to be with this. I mean, it's Bayern Munich, and we didn't even put a guaranteed win. We're saying a win or draw against Stuttgart. Of course, then we also have Ingolstadt against Borussia Mönchengladbach. Mönchengladbach to win or draw.
Yeah.
Mönchengladbach, another team on some fine form.
Mm-hmm.
And looking at the Serie A, AC Milan, Juventus, Juve to win or draw.
Mm.
Odds of 1.25. You don't think AC Milan stand any chance of winning something in this match?
Not really. I think the pressure is really getting to them since Mihailović is on a hot seat.
Yeah,
he hasn't really been doing so well in the recent games, and the Serie A is so unforgiving.
And Juventus are not the kind of team that really have any pity on whether you're.
Yes, and you know the funny thing is that they're out of the Champions League, so what's there to fight for if not the Serie A? Then the finals of the cup.
Domestic double is
more or less what they're looking for
the season. Mm-hmm. Napoli Verona. Now normally would have said now I'll be sure. I mean Napoli to win yet, but. With Higuain out for 4 matches, I mean, where are the goals coming from? I mean, they were just recreating the Holy Trinity once again up front for Napoli, and Higuain has to go and break ranks and get himself banned for a very, very silly, silly act. I mean, why would you go after a referee? But you still think Napoli would defeat Verona?
Yes, Napoli still, you know, coming as a wounded lion, they will be going, you know, all guns blazing. Mm. And Napoli still have the attacking potency, you know, in that team. Hamsik, Insigne, talking about even Caleon. All these players can actually do a lot for this team, regardless of Higuain, not the 30 goals being scored, not being available. But I still believe they're at home, you know, and they will get Verona.
All right, let's look at Roma Bologna. Despite Bologna having one or two patches this season, inconsistency has been their middle name.
Mm.
And they're coming up against a Roma side that resurgency
has been
their own middle name. And 1.33 are the odds, eight or very low odds. Everybody expects Roma to win this one.
Definitely, Perotti, El Shaarawy, Salah. Those are the three players that you just need to think about and then forget about Bologna.
Forget about
anything, really.
You wouldn't want any Bolognese person to meet you right now. They won't be too happy with you. All right, moving to the Primera Liga. We have Espanyol versus Atletico Madrid. We give Atletico Madrid to win or draw in what is the lesser classical.
Between the lesser
Catalan and the lesser Madrid side. Atletico Madrid 1.19 to win. To win or draw, and we're playing safe with that. Real Madrid, Eibar, no brainer. Real Madrid to win. In fact, the odds for Real Madrid to win or draw in this one are 1.02.
Yes,
almost pointless to bet on that. Exactly. I mean, you bet 100,000, you get 2K or so. That's how much Real Madrid are expected to win that one. Valencia, Sevilla. We saw Sevilla come back against Bilbao in the Europa League.
Yeah.
They're a very impressive team. The odds are 1.57 for them to win or draw.
I think.
Away to Valencia. Valencia, very terrible form this season.
Yeah.
This could just be something that will really boost your list, of course, if it comes through.
Definitely. Because it's unfair. You know, Valencia have been so terrible. You want to put Sevilla's odds at even at 1.3, but 1.5 is really generous. Yeah.
Real Sociedad, Barcelona.
Mm.
Barcelona to win or draw and the odds are this high. Is there any reason for that?
Because of Barcelona's form at Real Sociedad Stadium.
Yeah, could it be? That mean David Moyes came and immediately handed them a loss straight away.
Yes, straight away. Everyone beats Barcelona at Real Sociedad. It's almost a given. Wow. You know? So I think...
But not odds, this time.
Well, this time, even with the Suarez thing coming in, and Barcelona have that Champions League game as well in the middle of the week. But they would want to get that win. They do need that win, actually.
All right, EPL. We never ever pick odds on EPL, but this time we decided to. And we're not even looking at it. We're going straight for under 2.5 goals, Sunderland, Leicester. And we both agree that this is not a game that will be very high scoring.
Yes.
A lot of caution in this game.
Leicester's last five games, 1-0 wins, and then that draw against West Brom, which was the only over 2.5.
And
games.
Sunderland not conceding too many, but not scoring either.
Yes.
So we're looking at a 0-0, a 1-1.
A 1-0 to Leicester.
1-0 to Leicester, okay. Liverpool, Stoke City, over 2.5 goals in this one.
And I blame Jurgen Klopp.
So you believe that both teams will throw caution to the wind and attack? I mean, they're both very attacking sides. You have Arnautovic, you have Boyan, you have Shaqiri. You have Walters on the other end. You have a resurgent Origi.
Yeah.
You have Storage, Coutinho.
Mm.
Lallana,
they'll both go for
the jugular,
and they will want to score goals. So mm-hmm. I expect a three goal thriller at least. You know,
2-1,
3-2, even a 3-2,
okay,
4-4 draw. If you're
wow, okay, so it's over 2.5 on that one. Aston Villa, Bournemouth. Aston Villa almost gone. Bournemouth having a pretty decent run,
mm-hmm.
and we're picking Bournemouth to win or draw this one.
Yeah, Bournemouth, you know, they've really been impressive in the season. Mm-hmm. I remember at a point in time, Bournemouth looked like the relegation threatened team. And then they started picking up wins when they learned how to play in the Premier League. Aston Villa, unfortunately, having flirting with relegation, they're really more or less going down. They haven't been on any kind of form at all, losing about 5, 6, even 7 games so far in a row. And I think Bournemouth are safe enough to say that they will at least draw this game.
All right, and finally, Manchester City versus West Brom. Odds at 1.05. For Manchester City to win or draw this one at home. We're not even confident enough to give Man City a straight win at home.
Yeah, you know, Man City, they've been funny, you know, but since De Bruyne has come back, you might even want to give them a win, actually. But to be on the safe side, because we want those total odds, you don't want one game to take out all these odds and make you lose your money. Mm. So that win or draw is the safest bet for Manchester City.
All right, so you've seen the total odds are 171.7. You put... I mean, 100 naira on it, that's 17 grand, 100. You put 1,000 naira on it, I mean, we're talking 171,000.
I'm actually even thinking,
you're thinking about to play
500.
You know that, you're scumping.
It makes
a lot of sense. All right, we'll soon be ending the program, but we can't go without talking about the big three.
Yes.
Three fixtures we picked for this weekend. Three major fixtures. Of course, the three fixtures we have picked, we have Tottenham Hotspur versus Manchester United, and we have West Ham versus Arsenal, and of course, we have
Schalke versus Dortmund.
And looking at the first fixture of these three, I think we should start in England, West Ham versus Arsenal. And of course, West Ham, they are unbeaten in their last six fixtures in the league. They're just 3 points off the Champions League places. For Arsenal, currently 11 points behind leaders Leicester, and they have won 4 of their last 5 EPL matches at Upton Park. So
yeah,
Arsenal have a good record at Upton Park.
Mm-hmm.
West Ham won this. Arsenal won this. Who's going to win this one?
I really want to give it to Arsenal. Looking at their form in the past 2 games in the league, 2 wins, good for them. They're starting to get better. West Ham, yes, a lot of things, you would blame the referee because of the way they've had to draw 3 games in a row,
yeah.
You know, and it's not really been their forte in terms of giving away points. You know, but West Ham unbeaten in 9, you know, not really the team you would want to beat at Bowling Ground. Payet has been fantastic.
He has been very fantastic. And unless we forget, it's not just that Payet has been good. We've had the big part players.
Yes.
Lanzini has come through when he needs to. And the Carroll has come through when he needs to.
And the Carroll has come through. And even, you know, Victor Moses, Emenike has played his role as a team player.
And then we can't forget Cresswell and Co at the back.
Mm-hmm.
They've done their job at the back too.
Yes.
So what will Arsenal have to do to overcome this stubborn side?
Play their football, really. Mm. It's about playing their football, because there's really nothing you can't bring against this West Ham side and say that, okay, we're better than that. We're going to do this against West Ham. They're almost ready for anything, West Ham. And they've been built to play their own football which is universal in my opinion.
And they have the aggression of their coach.
Yes. You see, like, you know, it's that aggression that he brings to that
West Ham side. Hotspot, West Ham, Arsenal. Who wins this one?
I would give it to Arsenal. Arsenal's form, Wenger's form, the last 16 games. Yeah, at Bullion Ground, 9 wins, 5 draws and 2 losses. So
I'm going for the draw, because I mean, I never really want to write off West Ham. You know, they are not a team you write off easily. Alright, let's stay in England. Let's look at the next one. It's Tottenham Hotspur versus Manchester United. And what will surprise most people, Tottenham have considered the fewest goals in the league this season.
Mm-hmm.
And they're just 7 points behind Leicester. They're in second. That's not the surprise. The surprise that Man United... they haven't lost at White Hart Lane
since
2001. How is that possible? I mean, we've had David Moyes as manager of this club, and they're unbeaten since 2001 in the league at White Hart Lane.
Yeah.
But this weekend, do you think this Martial, Rashford, these young guns, do you think they have what it takes to overcome Tottenham's own young guns? I mean, those boys,
Kevin Zima.
I mean, you have Dele Alli, Harry King,
yes,
Ryan Mason,
Alderweireld.
I mean, do United's young guns have what it takes to overcome Tottenham's young guns?
I think one thing that Tottenham has to be wary of is complacency. If they're complacent against this Man United team, they will definitely punish Tottenham. And they have the energy, Tottenham, you know. The midfield has been fantastic. Dele Alli, Dembele, Eric Dier. They've just been really great, you know. And I think that's where Tottenham have to actually win the game. If they can take that midfield battle and win it, they more or less are likely going to win. And you can't take Harry Kane out from not scoring. Yeah.
But now they've seen a United side that seems to boycott the midfield and is moving down the flanks once again.
Mm-hmm.
Do you think this will affect Tottenham, particularly as their fullbacks are very attacking? You know, players getting into that pocket of space behind the fullbacks.
One thing I'm worried about from Manchester United is the pace on the flanks.
Mm.
You know, Van Gaal has started this thing where he's putting Lingard as a 10 and Mata
as on the right.
It gave Man United the goal in their game against Everton. Yes, but you know, with that lack of pace, you can see Danny Rose tracking back on time. You can see Kyle Walker tracking back on time. And if Martial keeps cutting in, you know, there's really not much of an option on the left, except if Rojo or whoever is in left back for Man United is coming to give that.
Right. Since you mentioned Rojo, let's go to the first. Blaine is a doubt.
Yes, Blaine is doubtful.
He's been reading the game very well. He's a player who I think could have watched Harry Kane's movements. Do you think if Blaine doesn't play this match, that could be a potential banana skin for Manchester United?
Definitely. You know, Blaine and Smalling contributed to 13 clean sheets that Man United have had this season. Let's not forget that Man United had the most clean sheets in the league this season.
Mm.
And that's really something you can't write off, you know. Apart from the fact that, yes, most of it has been David De Gea, the Blaine Smalling factor has really contributed. And, you know, looking at the distribution as well, that defence, you know, Blaine usually comes out with the ball, sometimes Smalling. They give those long balls to the flanks that Man United need to attack. Fosu-Mensah, if he comes in to play that centre-back position, can't really give you that
guarantee. Really. He can give you pace, but he's not that intelligent.
Yeah, he's not that
intelligent. All right, let's look at the final fixture. And for this one, we're leaving England for our final fixture. We're going straight to Germany. It's Schalke 04 versus Borussia Dortmund. And now, Dortmund currently on a 20-match unbeaten run since December.
Mm-hmm.
They're 5 points behind Bayern Munich. For Schalke, unbeaten at home in the league since January, and they are 1 point off the Champions League places.
Yes.
They are like seventh, but only one point between them and fourth place.
Yes.
And about 3 points between them and third place.
Yes.
So both teams have a lot to play for in this, and this is a derby.
Yes, it's one of the
biggest derby. Who wins this one?
Biggest derby in Germany, in my opinion. Dortmund need to keep up with Bayern Munich. I'm almost certain that by the time Dortmund are playing this game, they'll be 8 points behind Bayern Munich.
Do you think that Dortmund might have had one eye on this game when they were playing Liverpool?
Yes, definitely. I saw in that game, Aubameyang came off.
Yeah.
Of course, Eric Durm came off because of a concussion that he suffered in the early end of the first half. But it was almost, Dortmund really didn't go so far in taking Liverpool out of the game. You know,
yeah.
And you always have that second leg. That's what was ringing in Thomas Tuchel's head. And they got that goal they needed. Going against Bayern Munich, they want to win the league. They want to at least challenge Bayern Munich.
To the very end.
And they also want to give their fans something to celebrate against Schalke. So it's a must-win for Dortmund. Schalke, on the other hand, must win this game as well. Unfortunately, both teams can't win because Schalke need to keep up with that Champions League spot. They're competing with Bayern, with Mönchengladbach. They're competing with Hertha Berlin, you know, and probably Leverkusen could be in the mix as well. So they really need to get that
one. And for Schalke, you get the difficult games out of the way.
Mm-hmm.
You've done 50% of the job.
Yes, exactly. And the last time these two teams met, Dortmund won that one. So the bragging rights are there.
All right. So Schalke, Dortmund, let me put you on the hot spot.
I really don't want to call this one, but I would say Schalke to draw this game with Dortmund, because I can't really write off Schalke at the moment.
Schalke to draw this game with Dortmund. All right. You heard him, and that's our show for this week. You just to let you know, you can follow us on Instagram and on Twitter at DaBigWeekend. That's DaBigWeekend. Of course, it's at the bottom left of your screen. You can see it right there. Many thanks, Biola Obiwole, for being here today. It's been a great show.
Thank you,
fresh show. Of course, you can still watch the show later. Just look for search for Core TV News on YouTube. The program will be available for you to watch anytime. Many thanks to you if you've tuned in. The Big Weekend will be back 5:30 p.m. next week. Till then, have a lovely, lovely weekend. And please, if you can put your money where your mouth is, why not? Go ahead, have some fun. Enjoy. Good night.
TV News now live on all Androids.
Welcome to Core TV Primetime News.
Download Core TV News app from your Play Store. Click on the menu to see all our top stories from politics, sports, business, foreign news and live TV to watch us live on your mobile.
I want to know why I should be believing them.
You can also click on video to see all our YouTube videos, Call TV News, our 24-hour news station.